that were submitted or no plans for development at this time. That's not saying it couldn't happen in the future. A lot of times businesses or property owners have the street vacated because they don't want public access in and out there. Especially if they own both sides of the street, they don't want people just driving back there, you know, when they don't have a purpose to go back there.
Okay, because I do see that sometimes. And so
it could be why, I'm not saying it is, but it could be one of the reasons they're requesting the vacation.
Well, it was almost my concern, because once they boarded up the windows and everything, people stopped breaking in that place. That was my concern. And I haven't had any problems since they did that. They, I guess, Gardner owns that. But I was wondering if anything was going to happen there.
There's nothing that I'm aware of that's planned right now. I can tell you that normally when stuff is vacated, they usually have some sort of plans for development, or they just want to keep the public out. It could be either reason. I can't.
Well, I don't know how they're going to keep the public out when there's access out to Eureka Road.
They're only vacating the northern portion of that street. From Eureka up to those driveways of the businesses, it's going to remain public.
Okay. The reason I wanted to know is I've lived in that house 62 years. So I wanted to know if there was going to be sewers put up there and everything.
Through the chair, I really can't address that. You'll need to contact Keith Bach at the DPW to see if there are any plans for sewer, water, or anything going through there.
Okay. So in other words, what you're saying ultimately is that it's the public is not going to have access to up to that end of the street, and
it's no longer going to be a public street, city-owned public street. It will be owned by the property owner to the east and the other half to the property owner to the west. It will become a portion of their property.
Okay. All right.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you.
Thank you. Any other questions? I'm looking for a motion.
Make a motion.
I have a motion by Ms. Ross, supported by?
I'll support.
Mr. Simeon. I have a motion by Ms. Ross, supported by Mr. Simeon, that we approve and forward to the City Council. All in favor?
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carried. Next item, administrative action, case number 18-45A, site plan, 22339 Goddard, Midtown Plaza Building and Parking. Petitioner postponed until August 7th today. Parcel 60-057-02-0001-304. In the northerly 100 feet of parcel 60-057-02-0054-000 of the northeast quarter section 21, P.3S or .10E, City of Taylor, Wayne County, Michigan. The property is located on the southeast corner of Goddard and Pardee. Proposed construction of 9,240 square foot building addition and an additional 17 space parking lot at the southeast corner of the site. And is the petitioner here?
Your Honor, the petitioner is here. My name is Paul Miller. I'm an attorney for Petitioner Branden Investments. Also to my left is Simon Gulla, who is the owner of Branden Investments. In addition, Emily Mallory, who is our architect, with Sarah, Mark, Marco, and Associates Inc. as well.
Thank you. Want to tell us a little bit about what we're doing?
Yes, Your Honor. As the commissioners have noted, this is an additional 2,130 square feet to an existing structure located at Goddard and Pardee Road. The construction is going to, the facade is essentially going to continue to look city engineers of the county did copious review of the site plan. They made numerous changes and recommendations and suggestions. Based upon that, our architects have revised the plans and specifications that have been submitted both to McKenna as well as to everybody here. At this point, if I may, Emma will do a little bit about the presentation on the facade. And then one of the big issues that was discussed previously was the parking lot. So that would be two items that I would ask that Emily Mallory identify for the commission.
All right, we appreciate that. Thank you.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Like Paul said, my name is Emily Mallory. I'm a Sarah Marco Associates. We're architects on this project. We're proposing the addition to this, to the existing building. We are following the exact same building materials of what is there to continue a cohesive facade to make it still look like one building. We're following the existing construction, of what the existing building is like. In addition, we're going to propose parking in the rear of the site, on the rear parcel. We have worked before, we have a layout that has a 90-degree parking. However, there were only the 10-foot setbacks on that. McKenna had proposed in their last, or their second to last review, their first review, they had proposed that we develop a 90-degree, or a angled parking with one-way circulation and comply with the 20-foot setbacks of that site. We came up, they developed that as well, that is in the site plan packet that we were given. Based on my conversation with McKenna today, they had said that based on their review letter that they had just issued this week, and based on Laura's review as well, that we are in full compliance with the city ordinance as far as parking requirements, the whole scheme. The first scheme was the 93 parking, we had 82 parking spaces, and on the angle we provide 74 parking spaces, which is both are more than adequate to provide sufficient parking to the building addition and to the existing tenants that are in the existing building.
All right, thank you.
Would you explain to the board what the ordinance provides on parking? Can you say more than sufficient?
I'm sorry. The ordinance, as far as the use groups that are there and a proposed retail use, we're unaware of what the tenant will be at this time, but we're required to have 61 parking spaces. With both schemes, we are in excess of the parking to provide the adequate parking for them.
All right, well, thank you so much. Ms. Bell.
Through the chair, to the commission and to the audience. The architect has redesigned the plans kind of to facilitate, so we usually put conditions on them, extra conditions. They tried to comply with everything exactly to the T to the ordinance on these revised plans. Part of that is the 20-foot buffer around the rear parking lot. And when you look at the two, so now they've offered two options up. The 10-foot buffer with the berm and the 20-foot wide buffer with the angled parking. We re-reviewed this again at ARC. McKenna has also re-reviewed it, and both my and McKenna's recommendation is to stick with the 10-foot buffer because it provides more better circulation in there than angle parking and parallel parking along the side, and we don't feel it would serve any good purpose on such a small lot. If it was a larger lot, it might make sense to go with the 20-foot wide buffer. But we feel that that is sufficient. McKenna has resubmitted a review letter where the revised plans were reviewed. I'm just going to highlight some of the changes in their letter. They talked about the building addition height. They feel now the proposed building addition height is appropriate because it matches the existing building, current building. We find that the proposed building addition has a compliant front yard setback. The applicant must bring a sample board of the proposed building materials to the Planning Commission for their approval, which I believe they have done so.
The brick and the limestone.
Could we have that passed up?
At the May 20th, 2019 site plan, the proposed 10-foot wide buffer revised July 16, 2019 plan provides a 20-foot wide buffer area on the east, west, and south sides of the parking extension with PVC fencing. Section 16.02U of the zoning ordinance allows the planning commission to waive in whole or part provisions of the landscaping section under several conditions, including dimensional conditions unique to the parcel. The larger buffer area reduces the number of new parking spaces provided. If the planning commission determines the need to provide new parking spaces will benefit the site more than the increased buffer area, the proposed 20-foot buffer area could be reduced back down. A total of 61 off-street parking spaces are required, which includes the new addition. The revised site plan provides 74 off-street parking spaces. The minimum parking requirement would be met either way with option A or option B. The revised plan also